UFC fight is not over until the referee says so. It is never easy to get back into the fight, but there were spectacular UFC comebacks from time to time, especially if your rival is a man who attacks all the time. When you're in the problem, you should run for your life. But the octagon is a limited area. So, wherever you go, your angry opponent might wait and bash you. But some real warriors showed how spectacular the power of comeback could be. This is the list of top 5 UFC comebacks. Number 5. Team Botch vs. Yushin Okami, UFC 144. The date of this clash was February 26, 2012. Yushin Okami was a better wrestler in this match. Okami took Botch down many times. He had the mount, almost finished the fight with an arm triangle in the second round. Botch literally did nothing for 2 rounds, but in the third, everything changed. Team Botch opened with a good right hook early on and stunned Thunder. He continued landing shots, and a great right high kick was followed by a few devastating right hands. Yushin Okami was on the fence. Right clinch uppercut knocked Okami out. Team Botch delivered few more strikes on the ground, but it was already too late for Japanese Warrior. The referee stopped the fight. What a spectacular comeback! 2 rounds of nothing. Third round, we saw a totally different man. Number 4. Travis Brown vs. Alistair Overeem, UFC Fight Night 26. Have you ever wondered how much an Octagon Warrior can handle? Well, Travis Brown is a real example of an Iron Man. We've seen one of the best UFC comebacks on August 17, 2013. Alistair Overeem pushed him against the fence and took him down early on. This flurry of punches that Alistair Overeem delivered had to hurt. Hapo was on his knees while the Demolition Man was landing brutal right uppercuts over and over. Then he tried to stand up, but the Dutchman maintained the control of his back and didn't stop the punching barrage. He continued delivering knees too, but after 4 minutes in the first round, Travis Brown shocked everybody. He landed a tremendous left front kick to Overeem's chin and knocked him down. The strike didn't look deadly in the first place, but the Hawaiian landed 3 more punches on the ground to win the match. One of the greatest UFC comebacks. Number 3. Matt Hughes vs. Frank Trigg, UFC 52. The UFC former welterweight champion Matt Hughes has really had a hard time versus Frank Trigg. Trigg rocked Hughes early on with a brutal left cross and landed so many brutal punches on the ground. Everybody thought the match is over, except the former wrestling legend. Interestingly, the commentator said that these two guys could compete in wrestling. The two faced at UFC 52 on April 16, 25. Hughes survived over 20 brutal punches on the ground and a rare naked choke attempt, then somehow stood up. Matt Hughes performed the move of the fight seconds later, when he grabbed Frank Trigg, carried him across the octagon and slammed him off the floor. Is this guy a Hulk or what? Matt secured the side control position and took over the control of the fight. Matt Hughes successfully dominated rival's back and ended the fight via outstanding a rare naked choke after 4 minutes in the first round, after such a brutal bashing. It was one of the best UFC comebacks ever seen. Hughes survived an impossible thing. Number 2. Anderson Silva vs. Charles Sonnen, UFC 159. Many older UFC fans wonder how Charles Sonnen could lose this match. He controlled it during the 4 rounds. Well, Charles should only stay away from Silva in the 5th, and he would have won the match. I'd say it was one of the most stupid decisions a fighter could make. In the first round, Sonnen was on the top almost all the time. The same thing continued throughout 2nd and 3rd. The American gangster successfully controlled the fight and won all 4 rounds on the scorecards. But the 5th round will be remembered forever. Charles Sonnen wanted the victory at all costs and tried to rain punches off the top. But the spider did an unbelievable thing. It was a triangle armbar which secured the victory only 2 minutes before the end of the match. He choked out Charles Sonnen, April 28th. 2013, it was the day of one of the best UFC comebacks ever. Number 1. Chuck Kongo vs. Pat Barry, UFC Live 4. Well, If there is an impossible comeback, this is a real example. Jack Longo is on the list of the best UFC comebacks because he is a Mr. Mission Impossible. Is there a better way to describe the outcome of UFC Live 4 main event from June 27, 2011? Pat Barry stunned Longo with a brutal right hook. While the French fighter was on the ground, HD was attacking like a maniac and went in for the kill. Jack Longo stood up on his knees and then received another 4 or 5 punches. The commentator even said the fight was over. Another right hand knocked Jack down. Somehow Jack Longo, one of the dirtiest MMA fighters, survived the onslaught and tried to stand up. Dan Mirigueta didn't stop the match yet, and it was a tremendous decision. Longo was pulling back and landed a big right hand that wobbled HD. Dan Barry goes for a left hook, but Longo's right hand hits the chin. Good night! Longo won via first round KO. Unbelievable! The French heavyweight delivered two more right hands on the ground to secure a victory. I'd also say it was the best of all UFC comebacks. Well, we hope you liked our list of top 5 UFC comebacks. If you'd like to add another fighter to this list, another comeback, maybe you know another great example we missed, please leave us a comment. New ideas are always welcome. You can always rate and subscribe, and please follow us at bestoplistsbg.com.